Hey everybody, welcome into this week's episode of Tony's Spot on Fishing. I'm your host, Tony Krizak, and this week we got a real special treat for you. We're back here on my old stomping grounds, the Fox River, and I got a couple good buddies with me, the owners of Mammoth Custom Lures. These guys are making some of the finest musky crankbaits on the market today. From shallow divers, deep divers, and everything in between, we're going to show you all their little toys that they got. It's unbelievable. But guys, welcome to the show. Dave.
Thanks for having us.
Ben, yeah, thanks having us out, or being out with us today. We're here in Montgomery, Illinois. This is one of our favorite hotbeds for muskies. We're going to show you how we can get these fish to go, and especially on these awesome crankbaits these guys are making. That's all this week on Tony's Spot on Fishing.
Basically, they'll sit near the bottom of that channel, wait for something to come overhead, and they can sweep up and grab it. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean we want to run deeper diving baits, that we want these baits to be always baiting bottom, but we just want it at least halfway into that strike zone so that these fish can come up and grab it and go right back down. Pretty much in Montgomery, just south of the pipe, it's that big tube. That's where you'll actually find that channel cuts real close here. They'll run all the way down. Actually, all the way down to about that first major point where the turned up tree is. And it's all good deep water. And then after that point, it kind of ventures off in the middle. What I like to do when we're in a little more current like this fishing the channel, is we'll angle our casts upriver, bring them down. I will at times just go straight out and come across the current. And if you're going to throw down current, because the actual river current is going to help work your lure, you don't want to retrieve when you're coming up current as fast. Because you're going to have that bait just move almost too quick, so you can actually slow it down when you're coming back up. But the most natural presentation is, of course, going with the flow of the current. That's how most of your bait fish are going to swim down current. Muskies realize that they're facing up current and they can come up and ambush and create that. Now we're out here. This is the very first part of March in the 2016 campaign. And we've been able to get out a couple times in the mid part and end part of February. And the nice thing about the river muskies is these fish feed all winter long. Now they're not feeding heavily, but they have to eat more than a lake muskie does. And the reason for that is they're always fighting current, so they're always burning off energy. So it's a lot easier to come out here and get one of these fish to eat. They're not necessarily so much looking for a reaction strike at this point, or trying to anger one or piss one off. It's literally just getting those fish to eat. Now, water's still pretty cold, probably about 40 degrees, and moving water does warm up quicker than a lake would. So as the day goes on and the air temps warm up, the water temp will slowly start to warm as well. But that brings us to the big question I always get asked when we start talking about these cold water muskies in the river is, how do you retrieve? Are you we working fast, slow, twitching? What do? Well, the answer is actually all of them. And basically, we just have to kind of let the current dictate how it's all going to play out. If we have a little bit higher water and a little stronger push, obviously when we're throwing upriver and bringing our baits down current, we're going to have to work it a little quicker to get the action going with the river pushing it. Now, we can do a stop and go retrieve where we just give it a little speed burst, let that bait pause. We can do integrate some twitches, try to make it look like an injured meal. Basically, anything we can do to find a pattern when we first get out here and we're searching. Sometimes they want it nothing but twitching and darting, so it looks like a dying shad or a little walleye or a little carp, a little sucker, whatever. Because that's the main forage base out here. Walleyes, suckers, carp, shad. So play around with your retrieves. You know, we can go slow, we can go fast, stop and go, we can twitch, straight retrieves. But you just have to play around with it until you figure out what it is that they are going to want. Now, we have the luxury today of having Ben and Dave with us from Mammoth Lures. So we got three baits in the water. So everybody's just kind of doing their own thing, trying to get these fish to react to something. And once we can get a pattern honed in, we can usually follow that pattern the rest of the day and be successful. We'll get fish following. Fish follow in the river just like they would in the lakes. We were out last weekend just field testing a couple baits with them. And we ended up hooking two. We lost both of them. And we each had three follows. So in the course of about 6 hours last weekend, we had action from eight muskies out here. The populations of muskies in this river are phenomenal. And I don't care if you're up from where it exits out of the chain all the way down to Yorkville, they're in the river system. You just gotta find them. Thankfully, we got a real nice hotbed right here in Montgomery. There's plenty of food for them. And we can usually have a good amount of muskies at any given time in this stretch from the dam to the bridge. Following any channels, and down here near the fallen tree, we can actually don't have to wade out too far to get into some good fishable water. But as we continue north towards the dam, we'll eventually start working our way a little further out, because what we run into is the pea gravel beds. These pea gravel beds are actually a good spawning platform. The walleyes will spawn across it. It's fairly sandy enough that muskies will use it to spawn as well. And the biggest reason that we like fishing it this early is all the food is actually up here. Now, there's a reason there's a lot of food up here. Just probably 15 to 20 yards from the dam on the west side is a long rock barn. Actually cuts down a lot of the current on this west end. So the shallow flat will actually be fairly calm in comparison to the rest of the river, even compared to the river channel. So suckers are up here, shad, the walleyes are around. So all the food that the muskies are eating are over here. And the number one thing with muskies, even in cold water, they'll always follow the food. So as long as you're seeing you have all your food in one section. And there's times we'll find them as shallow as just a couple feet of water. Everybody thinks there has to be this good amount of depth, and that's why they should really pound that river channel. Truth be told, even in the cold water, they're they're right here with the food. Most of our action when we were out here last week came off the shallow flats. The majority of our follows, the fish we stuck. Don't be afraid on a river system like the Fox to fish shallow this time of year. As long as there's food. Now, if you're on a shallow flat with raging currents, no, we don't want to fish that one. But this whole west side from the dam all the way down to this fallen tree, there's a lot less current. You know, hold that food source for us. Montgomery Dam. This was the first part of March and water conditions were cold, the weather was cold. When we first got there in the morning, we were actually having ice buildup on our guides. Line was freezing, the braided line was freezing, reels were freezing. It was just a rough morning altogether. And our camera guy was such a trooper. He was having wader issues. Early on, right off the bat, he ended up getting leaks in his waders, and it was very hard for him to stay in the water with us to get the footage we normally would have on Tony's Spot on Fishing. We actually all had wader issues, to be honest about it, at various points in the day, both myself and Ben and Dave, and that's one good safety point we definitely want to stress. Don't chance things in the cold water like that. If you're fishing in the late fall, the winter months, the early spring, when that water's still really cold, you know, you still have to worry about things like hypothermia and frostbite, even for that matter. So if you're not having the proper issues, or you're not having the proper clothing, you're gonna have these issues, it's not worth it. The safety aspect has to be there in full swing. So we actually ended up having to cut our day short. We only actually put in about a half day out there. But we did have some action. We had one fish that was very hot on one of my baits. We actually thought that she would go about, you know, upper 20s. She was definitely under 30. And the fish literally, I went into a figure eight. Fish came out of nowhere on me. Tried to eat the bait. And literally I had turned the bait out of its mouth. Should have been a fish we connected on. I pulled the trigger, I saw her mouth open, the gills flare, I locked up, set a hook on nothing. That fish actually turned off, went down to Ben, who was fishing behind me, and we actually ended up, he ended up raising that fish, and then lo and behold, Chris, within just a few minutes of that, actually ended up sticking a fish that we believe was that same fish that we had action from. But Ben and Dave both had multiple fish up on their baits on the mammoth lures. Those muskies will actually turn themselves sideways and come down the river. And when they do that, they're looking for food. So they'll turn their body sideways and they're heading from north to south with the flow of the river. And we'll see them dart out and come up on these baits. And that's really what we were having. The fish weren't hot on a bait following it in. We'd go into a figure eight and they were showing themselves on this particular day.
So two of the main lures that we are using here on the Fox today are the Whack Job and the Depth Changer 2-Piece by Mammoth Custom Lures. One great feature on these lures is the metal bill on the front here allows you to change the depth of which you want to run the lure. For example, if you want to run the lure shallow, you just bend the bill down a little bit. If you want to run the lure a little bit deeper, you just bend it up. And this allows you to hit multiple depth ranges at multiple speeds, and just messing with the bill throughout the day, you can see what the fish are moving on and just keep bending back to that bill exact depth range that you want, and you're able to get a pattern of what the fish like. And the depth changer two piece here, you can also bend the bill down. This one runs about 5 to 6 feet, and you can run it as deep as 7 to 8 feet just by bending the bill there. So two great options when you're fishing. You don't have to take out a bunch of crankbaits. You just need one, and you can change the depth range of which you want to run it. So it's a great option. These lures can be purchased at www.mammothcustomlures.com. We have four colors of each right now. So yeah, check us out.
There, Chris. Oh yeah. There we go.
About 28.
Yeah, nice fish.
Well, everybody, that's about all the time we have for this week, and we hope we shed some light on how to get some of these early season muskies to go out on the Fox here. Anytime, you know, we can throw baits when some of these lakes still may be ice covered, or now they are just starting to thaw out, but we can come out here all winter, all early spring, and get these fish to go. And thanks to these two gentlemen here, I'll tell you right now, the whack job from Mammoth Baits, man, that is my go-to bait in this cold water. We've had fish react to this thing when they won't react to anything else. It is worth its weight in gold, to say the least, on that bait. The design is unbelievable on it. And I'll tell you what, it's going to be awesome all season long out here on the Fox. It's got that good profile to it. It's a fat body bait. It's my new Fox River bait of choice, I can tell you that right now. Dave, Ben, I appreciate you guys being here.
Appreciate having us out. A lot of fun.
It was always a good time to be out on the water with you guys. Hey, for everybody at Spot On Fishing, we'll catch you next week. Until then, we'll see you on the water.